Hello everyone, I am Mete Hanuzun. Today, me and my teammates will present our exploratory data analysis. Firstly, our data set about predicting which people take a jab. Get the data set on drivendata.org. It is about people who take a jab. There are two vaccines, but we eliminated one of them, and we will use seasonal flu vaccines. As I said before, our goal is predict which people take a jab. In this prediction, we will use 27 different type of informations about people. In the last of the model gives as a number, it's a binary number, 0 or 1. 0 means that people will not take a jab. 1 is that it's a true. That is means people will take a jab. Vaccination is a key public health measure used to fight infectious disease. Considering the current situation in the world, getting vaccinated while fighting disease makes people stronger against disease and slows the spread of the disease. Next. You are currently viewing the snapshot of our features. There are both categorical and numerical values in the data we have. First of the data, there were two targets, but we eliminate one of them and select one of them. Our selected value is target is seasonal flu vaccines. Next. It is again a snapshot from our data. When we first look at the data, there are 26.7K samples and 31 features. Again, we had eliminated some features of the data set because some of them is outliers or etc. We will show you next feature next slides this. We use some methods while eliminating this data. Next. Our task is supervised because we give the model input and output data. It is a binary classification because we give both input and because we get 0 or 1 values. 0 means no, 1 means yes. Next.
Hello everyone, I'm İdris Tadelen. In this slide, we look for the features and descriptions. In this table, we are looking at the feature description of the data set. Data set provide us 31 column and all the feature descriptions tells us what we are searching on the dataset accordingly. Let's go on the next slide. In this distribution graph, we looked for our target feature is balanced or not. The number of those who has taken seasonal vaccine and those who has not seem to be quite close to each other on this distribution graph. We can go to next slide. As you can see in this box plot, we will look for distributions of attribute values. How did we decide the most related feature? with the help of correlation widget, we got the feature that best matches with our target value. We will mention and take a look at for the correlation table at the feature selection part. Our box plot indicates that there are few outliers and mostly distributions for behavioral larger gatherings and seasonal vaccine. So as our p-value 0.00, it tells us that it is not significant the behavioral larger gatherings to predict the vaccinated or not. As we can see in the second feature, most related behavioral touch face, it shows us the relations. We can go for the next slide. In this slide, outlier detection and drop session are discussed. Before the outlier detection and drop process, our data is consist of 26,707 sample. And in this context, we use local outliers factor and we find 1,395 outliers and we drop them from the data set. After the drop process, sample number decreases 25,323 samples accordingly.
Hi everyone, I am Mert İhsan. In our data, there were missing values in 7%. It's nearly 2,000 sample. Any feature is important. We don't want to lose them, and we will fill the missing values. We filled the empty places from the pre-process tool with random values, as you can see. We input missing value property views. In here, there are some missing values in our data. As you can see, I mark some of them. Then we fill them with random values, and there were no missing values. I will show them. Here, a feature statistic. We look at the statistic of the features since we filled the missing values. The missing values are zero, as you can see, because we filled them. Since most feature samples consist of zero and one, the mean value and sample is zero and max value is one, because the most features consist of zero and one. That's why we didn't normalize or scale operation. In feature selection, we apply Pearson correlation to find the features that are most related to our target value. As seen in the example, the first one is the most related to our target, and this sequence continues relation. We again look at the Pearson correlation to drop unnecessary features. Since the three features we found did not have any effect, so we dropped them. These features are respondent ID, health insurance, and child under 6 months. As you can see here, there is no effect to other features, so too low. So we dropped them. Another process is to encode categorical features. We use thread as ordinal from the containerized discrete variables option in here, as you can see. Thread as ordinal converts the variable into a single numeric variable enumerating the original values. There were 12 categorical features. Now we have converted them to numeric. So the number of categorical features became 0 and the number of numerics increased to 27. As you can see in here, the categorical variables shown and we applied encoding. Also it's dummy operation, the other name. We obtained the numeric features.
Not dummy operations, dummy variables.
Sorry hocam, dummy variables. My mistake. Thank you for listening.
Okay. So in the end, do you think that you are comfortable with the explorator data analysis and preprocessing?
Quite, hocam.
Okay, what you learned about your data, Metal, as a result of this analysis, what you learned about your data, what point, what most important thing for you? Can you zoom your slides again?
John?
Yes, Metal, for you. According to your opinion, what is the most important thing that you learned? Could you please turn off your microphone if you don't speak?
Okay.
Yes, Betan.
I think I learned sometimes we have to convert our data. Because our data is not available for soft learning values. Sometimes we can eliminate some data with some of the methods.
Well, I am not asking general things. I am asking for this project, in your data set at hand, what did you learn about that data set?
Hocam, first of all, the seasonal vaccine is balanced or not, we checked that. It's quite balanced, I think. First of all, we learned that. The other things, the correlation, we look at the Pearson correlation. The features are, some features related, most related with our target. We checked that. For example, behavioral large gatherings or kind of behavioral things. For example, touch to face, etc. These are most related with our target, and some of the features. Does not affect our target, so we drop them.
Okay, what about Idris? What did you learn? Most important things in your for your data set regarding to your data set.
I couldn't answer, sir.
Now you present the findings according to you. In that findings, what's the most important thing for you about your data set?
I think we can finalize the all big picture doing some processes by applying the...
So I have not asked you techniques. I have not asking you, what did you learn about EDA? I am not asking this. You present me what you see in your data, right? You say that I dropped this, I ignored this, I ate this. You tell me a lot of things. I am saying now, which one of is most important out of these facts for your data set?
I think. Feature selection. I think.
I am not asking techniques. I am not asking you techniques. I am asking you facts. For example, one of your friends said that I see that target values are balanced. This is very important for us. He said this. I am asking your opinion. What did you learn at the end of this analysis? What did you learn regarding to your data set?
Okay,
this is the fifth time I am asking the same question.
I agree with my friend. Okay. Okay, sir.
Is that all? I am asking your opinion. This was his opinion. What about you? What did you learn about your data set? Nothing. Okay, anybody would like to add? What's the most important thing you learned in your about your data set?
Like our senior project, it's the most important thing is data number, firstly.
Is that enough?
No, absolutely not. Balancing.
Okay, feature numbers.
Features numbers. Yes, it is.
Enough or not for the data set?
Yeah. Only feature numbers is not enough, but it is part of a important things.
For example, after pre-processing, how many features you have?
Excuse me?
It is how many features after pre-processing?
Sir, 25,000 and
features.
Pardon, sir. Hemen.
Okay, so you didn't learn. Do you understand my point? You didn't learn the data set. You are just talking about the techniques, data set, but you don't learn your data set. You have to learn. You have to, by heart, you can tell that there are 24 features, blah, blah, but you don't learn. So the main point of executing exploratory data analysis is that you learn, you get familiar with the data set. You understand? It's not on the reporting these and these, but you have to get familiar with your data set. So anybody, after 3 hours, 5 hours working with the data set, anybody should remember the number of the features. Am I right?
Yes.
You're right.
31 features. One of them target after the drop.
So do you understand my point?
Yes, we can. Yes.
So it's like that. After pre-processing, you should be answering that. For example, do you think that these features are enough to predict the target value? Maybe you would say, no, it's not enough. There are missing features. We need to collect more data, for example. Or when I ask you if the samples are enough, you would say yes or no after exploratory data analysis. But you are just doing the exploratory analysis because you need to do as a homework. It's not the point. After that, when you try to build your model, you will not be successful because you don't understand your data. You are just reporting something, but you need to understand your data. Do you get my point?
Yes, hocam.
Yes.
Okay, focus on your data better. And try to understand data. Maybe you need to add new features or remove features, but the point is there. You try to understand your data, get familiar with your data, handle your data, shape your data so that in the next phase you would have better models according to your data. Okay, do you answer that?
Yes,
teacher.
Okay, thank you for the presentation.
Thank you, Tojun.
Take care. Bye-bye.